Welcome to the series of lecture on finite element analysis. In this part, we are going to derive the element characteristic equation of longitudinal vibration problem. In the last part, we have discussed about what is vibration, how to define a vibration system, and what are the elements of vibrating system, and how to define the vibration system using simple harmonic motion, all these things. In simple words, we can say vibration is nothing but a repeated motion of a body with respect to a mean position. So to define this repeated motion, we are using the sinusoidal waveform, that is simple harmonic motion. That simple harmonic motion can be written either by using sine function or cosine function based on the amplitude. The important property of the simple harmonic motion is acceleration is proportional to the displacement. Using this property, we are going to convert the time domain governing differential equation into a frequency domain equation. We made a mathematical model of longitudinal vibration system in the last part. This is the governing differential equation in the frequency domain. It is a second order differential equation, d by dx of eax du by dx plus rho ax omega square u of x equal to 0. Here this is the angular frequency. The domain for this vibration system is x is varying from 0 to L. The boundary condition in the top end, it is fixed end. So x equal to 0, u equal to 0. In the free end, there is no external force is acting. So we are using boundary condition x equal to L, eax du by dx is equal to 0. If you want to solve this problem at this stage, if you see the order of governing differential equation, it is a second order governing differential equation. So if you want to solve this problem at this stage, the minimum order of polynomial required is second order polynomial. So we are not able to use the line element for solving this problem as it is, because line element we used only first order polynomial to define the line element, because it is a one-dimensional linear element. That is, if you want to use the one-dimensional line element, we have to reduce the order of differentiation by half. For that, we are going to use the weak formulation of this governing differential equation. So here, we are discussing how to convert the order of differentiation by using the weak formulation method. So we know that when we substitute any trial function to the governing differential equation, then the governing differential equation will become the residual function r of x. Once you have this r of x, we can apply the Galerkin's approach. According to Galerkin approach, multiply the residual function with some weight function v of x and integrate this product over the domain and equate it to 0. This is called the Galerkin equation. Now, at the end of this Galerkin equation, we are able to reduce the order of differentiation by half. That is why it is called a weak formulation. When you apply this Galerkin approach to this equation, in the residual function, we have two part. The first one is d by dx of eax du by dx, and then second part is rho ax omega square u of x. After multiplying the weight function, we have these two parts. This is the first part, integral 0 to L d by dx, eax du by dx multiplied by this weight function v of x dx, plus the second part is integral 0 to L rho a omega square u v of x dx equal to 0. The first term here, we have the differential operator inside this integration. So it is called the integral differential equation, which we have already discuss this. This integral differential equation can be solved by using integral biparts formula. So now we'll see how to apply the integral biparts formula. The integral biparts formula is this one: integral udv is equal to uv minus integral vdu. In our case, integral udv, u going to be v of x, and dv, d by dx of this one, this is going to be considered as v. So now u is u, v of x, v is eax du by dx, then we can apply this formula uv. So here uv, this is a v eax du by dx, and u, this is a uv term, minus integral 0 to L v du. This is v eax du by dx, then du, u is v of x, so dv by dx is the du, then dx. This is the, by integral by parts formula, we are getting this two part. Again, the remaining part is added here, this part, the second integral, integral 0 to L rho a omega square u v dx equal to 0. Now, what is this part? We know that eax du by dx is nothing but a force p of x and v of x, right? So, this is nothing but work done due to external force. For free vibration, there will not be any external force acting over the system. So, we can say this term is totally equal to 0. So, we can eliminate this term from our equation. So, what is remaining? We have minus integral 0 to L eax du by dx dv by dx plus this integration. Now, take this term, the other side of this equation. So, we will get this minus will become positive. So, integral 0 to L eax du by dx dv by dx into dx, the positive will become negative now. Integral 0 to L rho a omega square u v dx equal to 0. Now, if you see this part, here the order of differential operator is 1, du by dx and dv by dx. So, the second order differential equation is reduced to first order. So, that is why it is called the weak form of the governing differential equation of our longitudinal vibration problem. Minimum order of polynomial required to solve this equation is 1. So, we can use the one-dimensional line element to solve this problem at this stage. After converting the governing differential equation into weak form, we are going to apply the one-dimensional line element to make the finite element model. So, this is the weak form derived by using the Galerkin approach. So, integral 0 to L eax du by dx dv by dx into dx minus integral 0 to L rho a omega square u v dx equal to 0. Now, we are going to use the one-dimensional line element for solving this problem. What is one-dimensional element? It is a straight line with two end node 1 and 2. Here, the degrees of freedom we are assuming u1 and u2 because it is a displacement. So, we are using u. Why you are using u? Along the x direction, the displacement is u. So, u1 and u2. How to interpolate the field variable within the element? For this one, we know that u of x equal to n1 u1 plus n2 e2, where n1 and n2 are called shape function. In local coordinate system, n1 is equal to 1 minus x by l, n2 is equal to x by l. In this weak form, we are going to use u is equal to this one, n1 u1, n2 u2, and v can be considered as n1 or n2. So, now in this equation, when we use weight function v is equal to n1, we will get one equation. Similarly, when we use this n2 as the weight function, we will get the second equation. So, these two simultaneous equations can be formed as a element characteristic equation for this longitudinal vibration problem. How to get this element characteristic equation? We will see. The first term going to give us the stiffness matrix K of the element characteristic equation. This part we are going to get the mass matrix of the element characteristic equation of the vibration problem, that we will see. When we consider the weight function V is equal to N1, right? When you consider V equal to N1 in this equation, we will get integral 0 to L EA, instead of U, we are substituting N1 U1 plus N2 U2. Now, instead of V, first we are considering V equal to N1. So, dN1 by dx like that. Then second part, minus integral 0 to L rho A omega square, this is U, N1 U1 plus N2 U2. Again, this is V, weight function N1 dx equal to 0. Now, split this bracket term, so we will get a two integration term like this. integral 0 to L EA dN1 by dx dN1 by dx multiplied by U1 dx. We got this U1 we are getting. Similarly, second part integral 0 to L EA dN1 by d this dN1 by dx multiplied by dN2 by dx this U2 dx. Then coming to the second part minus integral 0 to L rho A omega square here N1 N1 2 N1 will come and this U1. Okay. Minus next integral 0 to L rho A omega square will get N1 and N2 U2. N1 N2 U2 dx equal to 0. So now this term going to be first K11 element of the stiffness matrix K11. This is going to give the element K12 element of the stiffness matrix. Here this term going to give the first element M11 mass matrix first element. This is M12 mass matrix second element of the mass matrix. We'll see how to evaluate. When we consider weight function V is equal to N2, then we can write the equation integral 0 to L EA. This is U, N1 U1 plus N2 U2. Here weight function is considered as N2. So dN2 by dx. Similarly, in the second part minus integral 0 to L rho A omega square. This is U, N1 U1 plus N2 U2. Here weight function is N2. Now split this bracket term. So we will get a two part. Integral 0 to L EA dN1 by dx dN2 by dx N1 by dN2 dx we get U1. Similarly, the second part will get dN2 by dx again dN2 by dx U2. Coming to this one integral minus integral 0 to L rho A omega square N1 multiplied by N2 with U1. So N1 N2 U1 dx. Then second one we have to get N2 multiply with N2 U2. So N2 N2 U2 dx. So this is going to be the stiffness matrix element K21. This is going to give the element K22. Here M21 and M22 will get. In general, stiffness matrix elements are defined like this. Kij is equal to integral 0 to L EAX dNi by dx dNj by dx into dx. And elements of the mass matrix is defined like this. Mij is equal to integral 0 to L rho A ni nj dx. Here omega square is taken outside this mass matrix. Now how to evaluate this stiffness matrix Kij? This Kij stiffness matrix evaluation already we discussed for bar problem. So we can refer the earlier part for bar problem. So we derived this stiffness matrix K is equal to EA by L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1, which is already done. So I am taking directly. Coming to this mass matrix, how to evaluate the mass matrix? Here for first element M11 integral 0 to L rho A N1 N1 is the 1 1 element dx. Substitute N1, N1 is 1 minus x by L, 1 minus x by L. Multiply these two, right, and do the integration, apply the limit. Finally, we are getting the value as rho AL by 3. Similarly, in case of M22, when you apply this N2 value, integral 0 to L rho A N2 N2. What is N2? N2 is x by L, x by L. So when you do the multiplication and after that integration, finally M22 value also we will get rho AL by 3. Then M12, M21 element. If you see M12 integral 0 to L rho A N1, this is N2, right? 1 minus x by L is N1, this is N2. Then multiply this one, do the integration, apply the limit. We are getting M12 value as rho AL by 6. Similarly, if you want to evaluate M21, M21 element of the mass matrix, integral 0 to L rho A N1 N2. similar to this we will get, so rho AL by 6. Arranging all the terms M11, M22, M12, M21, we will get the mass matrix, it's a 2 by 2 matrix. Rho AL by 6 is taken outside, common term, you will get 2, 1, 1, 2. So this 2 will come because this is rho AL by 3. So M11 and M22 is rho AL by 3, that is why we are getting 2, 1, 1, 2. So you have to remember this. After knowing the mass matrix, we can establish the element characteristic equation for the longitudinal vibration problem. So this is the element characteristic equation for this vibration problem. First, we have the stiffness matrix, AE by L, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. Then we have mass matrix, rho AL by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2, omega square. Then U1, U2 are degrees of freedom, nodal displacement. And the right hand side we have 0 because it is free vibration. In case of forced vibration, we will get some force component. Since we are dealing with the free vibration, we have 0 in the right hand side. Similarly, in case of a damped vibration, in addition to K matrix, this is a stiffness matrix K, this is mass matrix M. In case if you assume damping also, then we will get the damping matrix also. It is a free undamped vibration, so we are getting only stiffness matrix K, mass matrix M, and the arrangement will be like this. In general, you have to remember this one, K minus omega square M multiplied by U, nodal displacement, which is equal to 0. Now in this equation, if we want to solve this equation, we cannot solve because the right hand side is 0. So if you want to get the values of the omega, we have to apply the concept of eigen equation. In this equation, this is the element characteristic equation for the longitudinal vibration problem, K minus omega square M into multiply by U equal to 0. Now in this case, for any vibration, U cannot be 0. So there will be some amplitude of vibration, right? U denotes the amplitude. So U cannot be 0, then to satisfy this equation, only possibility is this part K minus omega square M should be 0, then only the equation will be satisfied. So when we consider this one, the K minus omega square M, if you want to make this equal to 0, then determinant of this K minus omega square M should be equal to 0. So then only this equation will be satisfied. Based on this condition, we are able to evaluate the values of omega square. So this equation, determinant K minus omega square M is equal to 0, is called a eigen equation. In mathematics, this type of equation is called a eigen equation you studied. Now this omega square is called the eigen value in mathematics. Here we are going to call it as frequency of vibration. And this eigen vector U is going to be called as eigen vector, which is going to define the amplitude of vibration. Based on the amplitude, we can derive the mode shape of the vibration also. So in the longitudinal vibration, we are assuming free undamped vibration. So in the finite element characteristic equation, we have only stiffness matrix and mass matrix. So the general format is K stiffness matrix minus omega square mass matrix M multiplied with the U matrix, which is equal to 0. There are two types of mass matrix possible. One mass matrix is consistent mass matrix, which is derived now. So which is a rho AL by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2. The another one is called a lumped mass matrix, which is an approximate mass matrix. So they will use this lumped mass matrix like this, rho AL by 2, 1, 0, 0, 1. What is this matrix? What is rho, mass density, multiply with AL. AL is the total volume of the element. That means rho AL is nothing but the total mass of the bar, which is divided by 2. That means the total mass is equally divided and given to node 1 and node 2. This is the approximate mass matrix or lumped mass matrix. Normally for solving the problem, we have to use this consistent mass matrix only. which will give you more accurate solution than this lumped mass matrix. So in the next part we will see one example problem in longitudinal vibration of the bar. Thank you for your passion listening.